the most criticized scene in the movie An Inconvenient Truth was showing that the combination of sea level rise and storm surge would flood the 9/11 memorial site. And people said, what a terrible exaggeration.
Hurricane Sandy slammed into New York City last night, flooding the World Trade Center site.
A decade after he first took his climate change crusade to the big screen, former U.S. Vice President Al Gore is back with An Inconvenient Sequel, Truth to Power.
The next generation would be justified in looking back at us and asking, what were you thinking? Couldn't you hear what the scientists were saying? Couldn't you hear what Mother Nature was screaming at you?
The film includes Gore's work to pass the Paris Climate Accords and had to be updated when President Trump announced he'd pull the U.S. out of the deal.
We always knew we were going to have to wait to see how the U.S. election came out and then what new policies there might be and how they felt and how to integrate them into the movie.
But Gore, ever the optimist, says the issue of climate change goes beyond politics.
The conservative Republican Trump-supporting mayor of Georgetown, Texas,
which is the reddest city in the reddest county in Texas, and I'm a conservative Republican,
made the decision to take his entire city 100% renewable, and the citizens there are saving money and the air is cleaner.
The less stuff you put in the air, the better it is.
Yeah.
I mean, common sense. You don't need scientists to debate.
Can I use that line?
You absolutely can.
The solutions are here now. We could see them on the horizon 10 years ago, but now they're here, and in many areas it's cheaper to use renewable energy and climate-friendly choices, and soon it will be everywhere.
It is right to save humanity. It is wrong to pollute this earth. It is right to give hope to the future generation.
In Hollywood, I'm David Daniel.